thinks my tractor's sexy. It really turns her on. She's always staring at me while I'm chugging along.
It all kind of started when Dad and a friend of his, Colin Clay, went to the Mystery Creek Field Days in 1977, I think it was, and they were walking down the line and they came across a vehicle that a chap up there had built, but he'd taken a TEA Fergie, which is a smaller one than this, and patched that into an old Morris commercial truck cab. They had a deck on it, and the story goes that when they were walking down there, Dad saw this, and he turned to Colin and he says, "Colin, me boy, I think we'll have to do something about that." They got home and he went down to the local service station, Mokatua Service Centre, which was in those days run by Donnie Marshall. And he said, "Donnie, we're going to put a TK Bedford cab on my Massey Fergie 65. And so it started. We'll get this side door up so we can get a bit of a look in here. And if we look right down inside here, we can see from the fan back, the motor, the transmission, the rear axle, that is the original farm tractor. All right, the gearbox, everything is as it was on the original Massey Fergie 65. The Bedford part, in other words, the tractor has had the front axle removed and all the cowls and things, of course. So the Bedford part starts from sort of down in here where the main part of the chassis is, where they joined it to keep it. From here forward, disregarding the motor, is original TK Bedford. So the front axle, the steering, everything else is as it was in the original truck. Suspension, okay. Front axle is all TK, but we have a block of wood down there now, which, because, and this happened before I ever saw it, they took a number of the springs out to soften the suspension up. You know, bearing in mind as a truck, it was made to carry several tons. And when you just sat in there with you and a couple of mates and a crater flag, and she was a bit heavy on and the beer used to froth up. Generally, it was dual wheeled. But if you were doing ploughing or the likes of that, you could take one dual off if you wanted. The gear linkages in here is just, I'm not sure what to say, except that it works. And if I reach into the cab, I'll rattle the lever a bit. And that's what we use to go switch between selection of gears, and then we've got forward and reverse and those sorts of things. So it looks horrible, but it works. What's happened here is the cables from the Eaton diff are now connected to the controls for the multi. So when we pull the knob up, we go to high multi, and down we go into low multi. So it works much the same as the original truck done, and it gives us another three forward gears. Well, we'll reach in here and we'll just take this very sophisticated handbrake out of the way. And you'll notice that we've got four pedals in the cab, whereas most would have three, so we have a clutch pedal. All farm tractors, even today, I believe, have left and right hand wheel brakes. And normally on the original tractor, they were mechanical. These have been converted to hydraulic operation. So we've got a left-hand wheel brake, right-hand wheel brake, or we can push them both together. It's one of those things, you just kind of rock your foot a wee bit to even the brakes out. Otherwise it can flick a wee bit to one side or the other, but that's no biggie. The brakes themselves come back and they are now connected through these rods down here, back up through the linkages. So we now have hydraulic master cylinders, one for each side. We had a bit of a concession here on the original concept. That was a piece of number 8 wire, and I just couldn't do that. I had to put a bit of chain in there, which is the next best thing. Down in here we have this Bowden cable coming through, connected to the PDO lever. I haven't got it hooked up inside yet, but that allows you to control the paddock off from inside the cab. And over on the other side, a cable yet to be fitted, connected to a linkage inside the cab, which was done by Dad, operates the three-point hydraulics. If you drove it as if you're driving a conventional tractor, except you're having a hell of a lot more fun. She likes the way it's pulling while we're tilling up the land. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really understands what gets me. She thinks my tractor's sexy. Not everybody's happy doing 20k. Talk with the radio. She says she's got a dream, and I ask what it is. She wants a little farm and a yard full of kids. One more teeny weeny ride before I And because there's no front brakes on it, you've got to be thinking ahead a bit. But it doesn't stop quite as quick as you think it might. The back wheels will lock up. Although we are going to put water in it to make it a bit heavier, and then it'll be more effective. She likes the way it's pulling while we're tilling up the land. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really understands what gets me. She thinks my tractor's sexy. 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 Not everybody's got one of these parked outside their house in town, mate. Just for you, Dad. Just for you, mate.